The best pitch that we have for Harpoon, because it's such a weird movie, is it's Polanski's Knife in the Water by way of Seinfeld characters. So it's got a bit of the weird tension, but it's also darkly comedic and involves selfish characters trying to survive out in the middle of the ocean. I mean, everyone always asks, like, why are you following people doing bad stuff? And I actually come at it from a place of compassion. I don't think bad people want to wake up and be bad people. But I'm interested in how they get there, and I feel like in a survival situation, what was the most interesting to me was selfish people trying to survive. And oftentimes I imagine myself in these situations where I could be heroic, and then I worry, I'm like, wait, what if I'm self-serving in this whole situation? So it's fun to explore the dynamics of close friends, but then also betrayal and distrust amongst them in a weird situation where they have to rely on each other to survive. I mean, genre for me is like a very cathartic experience. It's a chance to live out these situations that in reality we don't want to go anywhere near. But it evokes a certain emotion that perhaps a dramatic film or just a serious coming-of-age story or even a comedy may not resurrect. I'm interested in chasing the goosebumps, getting that adrenaline going, and imagining myself in these crazy and awful situations. And I think that's a kind of a fun ride for a lot of audience members as well when it comes to genre and horror-specific elements.
In terms of crazy situations, what was it like on set, on location? Can you talk a little bit about the actual filming process and if you have any particular fond or tragic memories from that?
I mean, what do they tell you? Don't shoot with kids, animals, or on the water. We didn't do kids or animals, but we were out in the ocean in the middle of Belize in Central America shooting a real crazy movie out there in the middle of the ocean. Aside from that, I had a wonderful crew, wonderful producers, and it went actually really well. The interiors of the boat, however, we shot in the middle of Calgary, Alberta, Canada. It's 2,000 kilometers from the closest ocean in the middle of winter in minus 30 weather. So that was probably the weird contrast, is shooting in two entirely different locations.
Can you tell us a little bit about the cast, the people you found to brave those conditions with you?
Absolutely. We had Emily Tyra and Christopher Gray we found through 360 management, and that was from a prior relationship we had, and I knew just in talking to them that they'd be a fantastic fit for the characters we were going in, and they bought into the risk that we were all trying to take with this movie and bending genres. Monroe Chambers I knew prior from seeing him in Turbo Kid, and then my producer Mike Peterson directed a movie called Knuckleball, and I edited that. And so my familiarity was from cutting the dailies of him playing this sort of psychopath in that movie, and it didn't totally click with me that he'd be right for our role in a kind of a trio friendship. I didn't want it to feel like an obvious tell that, you know, things are going to go wrong. But then he did a fantastic read, and I think it's a testament to his range, just how different he is from role to role. That's kind of how we found our three people, and then we got to do 3 days of rehearsal that Mike booked out for us, which doesn't happen on an indie movie. And so for 3 days, it was just me and the three casts in a hotel room, running lines and running the whole script each day until we refined it, until they found that kind of long-term friendship rapport and that we were able to kind of get all the problems out before we even went to camera.
I mean, you talked about taking chances. For films that do take chances, how vital are platforms like FrightFest in reaching a larger audience?
I mean, especially nowadays with the market where it's harder and harder to indies to break through, these festivals are where that kind of stuff happens. So, you know, for FrightFest to be championing movies that are taking risks, for better or worse, whether the risks pay off, it's important that they're allowed to happen. Otherwise, we're going to end up with a very stale market of movies. And so these festivals are important for pushing the medium. I want to see stuff that's challenging, that's taking risks. And you come to the festivals such as FrightFest, and that's where you find it. And so that's the fun part. It's also a chance to put a movie in front of lively audiences that just want to have a great time.